My name is Lizzie Herrera, Program Associate here in the Horticulture Department, and in this video, I will show you how to construct your own soil moisture sensor. There are many types of sensors that you can use to measure soil moisture. In this example, we will be using Watermark brand sensors. The following instructions are based on the University of Arkansas System Division of Agriculture publication, FSA 57, titled, How to Prepare, Test, and Install Watermark Sensors, by Drs. Chris Henry, Paul Francis, and Leo Espinoza. The supplies you will need include 1/2-inch Schedule 40 PVC pipe with a 315 PSI wall. This grade and size of PVC pipe will allow the Watermark sensor to fit snug into the pipe. A Watermark soil moisture sensor, model 200SS. These sensors come with either a 5-foot or 15-foot long cable. For our example, we are using one with a 5-foot long cable. Blue PVC cement, electrical tape, a 1/2-inch PVC cap, a saw or PVC cutter, a permanent marker, and a drill. First, you will measure and mark the length of PVC pipe needed. In this example, we wanted the sensor to be 30 inches deep. It is recommended to cut the pipe at least 4 inches longer than your desired depth in order to make sure the sensor is easier to locate and take readings above ground. For this sensor, we will measure and cut the pipe at 34 inches. Generally, we recommend installing 2 sensors at each location, one at a shallow depth and one at a deeper depth. For more information on depth recommendations, contact your local cooperative extension office. Once your PVC is marked, use a saw or PVC cutter to cut the pipe to the desired length. Next, cut a 1-inch notch at the top of the PVC to allow room for the sensor wire to lay freely and not be pinched by the PVC cap. Now, drill a small 1/8-inch hole about 1/4 inch from the end of the pipe. This hole will help in draining the sensor in the event water gets inside the PVC. Next, take the Watermark sensor and feed the wire starting from the end with the 1/8-inch hole. Now you will secure the sensor into the pipe using blue PVC cement. Apply the cement to the sensor collar and inside the pipe. Make sure that the slot on the sensor is aligned with the hole so that the water can drain. Wipe off any excess cement so that the surface is smooth. You don't want any excess building up around the seam of the sensor and PVC pipe. Mark the desired installation depth starting from the end of the sensor. The sensor you see here is being marked at 12 inches for the demonstration purposes of this step. For manual RED sensors, such as the one in this example, it is recommended to only leave 2 to 4 inches of wire outside, just enough to connect to a manual reader. You can either loop the excess wire into the PVC or wrap it around the completed sensor. Once the wire is secured, use electrical tape to tape the PVC cap to the sensor. A good rule of thumb when installing Watermark sensors is to always plant a wet sensor. Prior to field installation, the Watermark sensor should be soaked overnight, preferably in the irrigation water that will be applied to the field. However, tap water can also be used. If time permits before installation, the new sensors can be conditioned through 2 wetting and drying cycles. First, soak the sensors overnight or at least halfway submerged and then allow them to dry during the day for about 30 to 48 hours. Next, test the sensors with the manual reader. The reading should be greater than 150 cB, which indicates the sensor is dry. Submerge the sensors again and test them using the manual reader. This time, the reader should be less than 5 cb, indicating the sensor is saturated. Let the sensors air dry once more for 30 to 48 hours and test again. The reading should once again be between 150 to 199 cb. Now, put the sensor back in the water and check with the manual reader after 2 minutes. Now the reading should return to less than 5 cb. After the sensors have been conditioned, keep the sensors submerged in water until installation. We hope this video was helpful in constructing your own soil moisture sensors. Check out part 2 of our Watermark sensor video series, where we will show you how to install your soil moisture sensors in the field. Sign up for our Arkansas Fruit, Vegetable, and Nut blog and stay up to date on information from our specialists on all things related to horticulture production in Arkansas. Special thank you to the Southern Sustainable Agriculture Research and Education Program for their support of this project. Thanks so much for watching!